Hi, in this video I will show you how to refurbish your coffee grinding unit on Seiko Royale and what you need to replace and how to replace it and why it's necessary when your machine is old and why you have to replace the parts that I will show you to replace. First, we'll replace the whole base, plastic base, on the unit, grinding unit, because there are some wears, and I will show you how to refurbish your coffee grinder and the dosing mechanism here that govern the quantity of the grind coffee inside your brew group. So first I want to show you what we going to replace first, the bases. So as you can see, there are two type of base for the grinding unit. So this one, the smaller, is for the old Seiko Royale, first generation Seiko Royale, and Magic also. It's smaller. And the other one, it look almost the same, is for the second generation and the third generation Seiko Royale and second generation Seiko Magic. So what is the difference? Most of the time, if your grinder, coffee grinder, is with screws attached to the base, you have the first generation Royale or Magic. If your grinder is attached with rubber tampons here, it's second or third generation Seiko Royale. So what I have is first generation, so I will replace this. And we can start with removing the cables and switches. Okay. So we have to remove the switch. I also will replace this switch because this one is old. You can see here, you can see it, it's a switch for the door. We have to remove it. Okay. And now we have to remove some of the screws here. Can open the door. Okay. Now we have to remove this. In this side, usually your machine will have rubber tampons, but they are old and break, and so I replace it with something else. So now we have two bolts here. We have to remove them. And from below you have two nuts. Okay, so this is free, this is free. We have to remove also the sensor for the water level. It's almost free, everything. I will remove the grinder. And the cable from the electronics. Okay, you can see how it's loose everything. Okay, so now you have to be very careful with this not to break it. Okay, and just for a moment. Of course, you have to clean here. Don't lose this rubber here. Okay. Now we have the base. So I have to move this, and I will show you in the next video how to repair the coffee grinder. For now, we leave it on one side. Of course, now we have to remove all these parts here and put it on the new base. And I will show you why I actually replace this big plastic. So now we have to remove this and the whole mechanism will go here. This here we have to clean it really good, and the reason why I have to replace the base is because this mechanism here start to wear here, and you have the brew group here and the coffee goes inside your brew group, but when this piece here is not stable, the coffee goes around your brew group, and when you open the door you can see a lot of coffee around your brew group. This problem occur after maybe 60-70,000 coffees if your machine makes. So now the only thing we will use is the metal parts. Because if you can see here, it's not good now. That's why we have new. Okay. So this is the old one. And we have brand new. Okay. So again, we put this one. And this one. Okay. So from this we don't need only bolts. We're going to need, okay, and this rubber here. Okay, this rubber and the bolts. Okay, this we put it in the trash. You don't need it. So we make this, and now we're going to assemble this piece here. You can see here, you push and it's ready. So now what we have to do is to clean this one from the coffee. Here is the switch inside. We want to be clean, maximum clean. Okay, and we are ready. So now we bring back the coffee machine. Of course, I will use okay. So you understand, it has to be clean. So now I will put this one here. Okay. And this lever here. So now I have to okay. After that, this piece here with the screws. I'm making everything fast because I don't want to bore you with the video to be too long, but you can clean better these pieces that you will reuse. Okay, so now everything is okay. Now we have to okay. One moment. Okay. So this one goes here. Of course, be careful with this. Okay, now you have to attach this here. It's not complicated, it needs time. For me, it's not a lot of time because I do it very often. This for people who do it one time, it may take longer. Okay, now this one goes here, and because I don't have this rubber tampons, I will use screws. So It's not a problem. If you have screws, use screws. If you, your tampons are rubbers, tampons are okay, use them. Okay, now we are ready to put the switch. Let me show you. You have to open the door, and it's really easy. Okay, it's on place. Now I have a new switch, and it's different from the other switches. It's look the same, but what is the difference between this switch and the other switches in your machine? It's very soft. It's the other are hard. When you have to press hard to make it on off. This one is very soft, so you can take a switch from somewhere else and put it here. So as you can see, it's simple. Remove one and the other one. Okay. Now we have to okay, so the switch is on place. You can do this, and now this one here. And we are almost ready. Okay. And now don't forget this spring here and this coil. Okay. Okay. From the other side maybe. Okay. So the base is only the sensor here for the water level. So now I have to refurbish the coffee grinder, and the machine is ready to be used many years more. So this is the first video. I will make second video how to refurbish your coffee grinder. Bye.